Hello, Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I render exposition of John 3:26-36. And they came, the Pharisee and Jews from Jerusalem, who just wanted to criticize, and they were not looking for anything, hypocrites. And they came unto John and said unto him, Rabbi, he that was with thee beyond Jordan, to whom thou bearest witness, that means Christ Jesus, behold, the same baptizeth, and all men come to him. Same baptizeth means his laborers were baptizing. Christ Jesus never baptized anyone in water. And John answered and said, a man can receive nothing except it be given him from heaven. He told them, you know, it's by the grace of God that you receive the gift to baptize people. And you can't do it from men. So you have to, it is from heaven you get it. So his baptism of John the Baptist was from heaven and not from men. Ye yourself bear me witness that I said, I am not the Christ, but that I am sent before him. That John the Baptist stressed that he is not the Christ, but he is a witness to the Christ and sent before him. He was sent before him to turn the Jews who had become the Jews of the flesh, not of the heart, to turn the Jews of the heart and make them in flesh their covenant with Abraham, to establish their covenant with Abraham in flesh and make them Jew of the heart. So that's why John the Baptist was baptizing men only in the name of Abraham, to make them sons of man or sons of Abraham. And Christ, they were handed over to Christ Jesus to be turned into sons of God. Sons of man are people who are salt of the earth. Of the earth was created Adam, and those who represented Adam, sons of man, only they were called salt of the earth. And those who became Jews of the flesh and they broke their covenant with Abraham, they were called sons of Satan, or tares, as in the parable of wheat and tares. He that hath the bride is the bridegroom. That means Christ Jesus is the bridegroom, and he has the bride. He came to have the virgins, produce virgins suitable for marriage with the God, his Father. But the friend of the bridegroom, which standeth and heareth him, rejoice greatly because of the bridegroom's voice. This my joy therefore is fulfilled. So John the Baptist said that his joy was to create sons of man so that he can produce brides. 10 virgins, remember, brides suitable for marriage with the Father God, or the Son, which is Christ Jesus. He must increase, but I must decrease. So his popularity or his mission must increase, because this is the age of Christ and not of the works or the rabbinic age. So rabbinic age was the previous one, and when the rabbi had become corrupt, so that age ended. So John the Baptist was an ideal rabbi, so he came to prepare sons of man for Christ Jesus. So his popularity must decrease, and the work of the Christ Jesus must increase. So the Christ Jesus work has dominated since then, and it has increased. So here John the Baptist is giving the what the effect is of his teaching. John the Baptist was a teacher and Christ Jesus was a preacher of gospel, teacher of moral laws, which is scripture, and preaching is gospel, which is cannot be written down in ink on paper. It is received through revelation. He that cometh from above is above all. So he that cometh from God is above all. So because he comes from above. He that is of the earth is earthly. So those who are sons of man, they are earthly. But he was son of God. He came from God. So the people who are sons of man, they are earthly, and speaketh of the earth. So they speaketh of the earth. That's what we call the, you know, the spirit of man knows the things of men, whereas the spirit of God knows the things of God. So John the Baptist was doing it under the spirit of man, while Christ Jesus was preaching gospel under the spirit of God, Holy Spirit with capital S. That Holy Spirit which is of the man is with small s, which is called common sense. He that cometh from heaven is above all. So he that comes from God is above all. That means the Son of God is greater than John the Baptist, as Christ Jesus stressed, you know, the least in the royal kingdom of God is greater than John the Baptist. And what he hath seen and heard, he testifieth, and no man receiveth his testimony. So Christ Jesus is testifying, but no one want to receive his testimony. He that hath received his testimony hath set to his seal that God is true. So those who have received the testimony of Christ Jesus, they have become sealed to serve God, and they have confirmed that God is true. Now the Yahweh is the demiurge God of the mythology of the Jewish creator of male and female. So he is a not real mythology, means mythological, man-made, imagined. But our Father in Christ Jesus, God, is absolutely true. He is real. He is not a mythology. For he whom God hath sent speaketh the words of God. For God giveth not the Spirit by measures unto him. So God has given all his wealth to Christ Jesus, not by measures, but everything. So because he was the anointed Christ, so he had all the powers of God. The Father loveth the Son and hath given all things into his hand. So this is nothing to explain, that Christ Jesus had all, he was God-like, but not God himself. That's why Christ Jesus, a master, can train his laborers to a standard, but the laborers do not become the master, equal to the master. So they are still below master. So Christ Jesus was sent by Father our God. So he was God-like, but not God. He had the very spirit of God. Still he was doing with the authority of God. He that believeth on the Son hath everlasting life. He that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abideth on him. That means those who don't believe in the gospel and they don't trust it, they will suffer in the Holocaust and other things.